U.S. Department of Transportation logo, Federal Highway Administration.
The box test is a workability test for slip-form paving concrete to assess the concrete's ability to maintain a vertical edge, as well as its ability to consolidate when energy is added through vibration. This video refers to AASHTO Provisional Test Method TP-137-20. This video demonstrates how to use the box test. This device is available on loan to agencies and contractors through the FHWA's Mobile Concrete Technology Center. The box test is made of three main pieces, a square base and two L-shaped sides. These latch together to form the box test. Inside the box test, it is wise to mark each side at 9.5 inches high. This is used when filling the box test with concrete. A vibrator is used for the consolidation of the concrete mix in the box test. A portable vibrator with a 1-inch square head and a vibration frequency of 12,500 vibrations per minute, or VPM, shall be used in accordance with the procedure of this method. Varying from these vibrator criteria will most likely yield dissimilar results. Choosing the right vibrator is very important for this test. Examples of commercially available electric vibrator motors meeting this include the Wico 992, the Wico SureSpeed at 12,500 VPM, the Wacker M1500, the Northrock Pro 1.5, or the MultiQ CV2A. The FHWA does not endorse commercial products, and we are mentioning them here for informational purposes only. The box test is filled with concrete from a representative concrete sample, so we will be following AASHTO R60-12 or ASTM C172/172M to take the sample. Set the base of the box test on a flat and level surface. Now, slide the two sides of the box down onto the base and latch them together. If your setup has latches on the base, connect them to the upper pieces of the box. Before you place the concrete, dampen the inside surfaces of the box test. This can be done with a wet sponge. Place the concrete in the box using a hand scoop or a spade, filling the box until the concrete is 9.5 inches high. During the concrete placement process, the concrete does not need to be rotted, vibrated, or the side of the box hit with a mallet. Level off the concrete at the top so that the height of the concrete on all four sides of the box is approximately 9.5 inches. Now consolidate the concrete by inserting a vibrator into the center of the concrete, pushing it down at a consistent rate for 3 seconds until it reaches the bottom, then pulling out in 3 seconds in the same fashion. Undo the clamps on the sides and bottom of the box test, and remove the sides of the box test by slowly lifting straight up, one side at a time. This simulates the end process of a concrete paver. The edges of the box test will show any potential issues with the edge slump, either from the top or the bottom. To determine any perceivable amount of slump, use a straight edge, such as an angle, and line it up next to the box test. Most box tests have latches on the base that connect the sides to the base of the box test. These are very useful in keeping the box test stable while filling and consolidating. The box test can also be utilized to judge the length of time that a concrete mix remains workable. By running the box test on the same concrete sample at multiple intervals of time, one can determine the time window in which the concrete consolidates appropriately. This can also be performed to determine the amount of admixture needed to keep a mixture workable for a given time. As we recently showed you, it is very important to lift the sides of the box test straight up when completing the procedure. If you pull them outwards, not only are you losing the simulation of a paver, it also tends to pull and tear at the sides of the box test, potentially warping the results. When you first start to learn this test method, it can help to have the rating template from the test procedure nearby when evaluating the results of the box test. As you gain experience with the box test, however, you will learn to easily differentiate between the four ratings without assistance. For more videos of other concrete materials and construction-related technologies, visit our website.
Learn more at www.fhwa.dot.gov. Follow the Federal Highway Administration on Facebook, Instagram, Flickr, LinkedIn, Twitter, and YouTube. The U.S. government does not endorse products or manufacturers. Trademarks or manufacturers' names appear in this video because they are considered essential to the objective of the video. They are included for informational purposes only and are not intended to reflect a preference, approval, or endorsement of any one product or entity. Except for any statutes and regulations cited, the contents of this video do not have the force and effect of law and are not meant to bind the public in any way. This video is intended only to provide information to the public regarding existing requirements under the law or agency's policies.